Agriculture is a culture obtained from a single spore, that is fungal spore, or a single cell, and it can be bacterial cell. Once a microorganism has been isolated and grown in pure culture, it becomes necessary to maintain the viability and purity of the microorganism by keeping the pure cultures free from contaminations. So what's preservation? To maintain pure culture for extended periods in a viable conditions without any genetic change is referred as preservation. The aim of preservation is to stop the cell division at a particular stage, that is to stop microbial growth or at least lower the growth rate. Due to this, toxic chemicals are not accumulated and hence viability of microorganism is not affected. There are a number of reasons why a microbiology laboratory needs stock cultures in good condition. And now let's see the objectives of preservation. To maintain isolated pure culture for extended periods in a viable conditions. Viable condition means active condition. And second one is to avoid the contamination. That is to avoid unwanted microorganism interfering with the pure culture. Is also prevented, and the third objective is to restrict genetic change, that is mutation. Let's check the application of preservation. It's mainly used for the academic use, then for the research purpose, and in fermentation industry and biotechnological field, we need pure culture for the research and development purposes, and when coming to the industries, we need pure culture for the production of industrial products such as antibiotics, amino acids, vitamins. Because if the culture is not pure, means there will be some unintended products will be produced that will be harmful. So in order to avoid that, we need pure culture. And in order to maintain a pure culture, preservation is required. Methods of preservation and maintenance of microbial culture is broadly divided into two types, the short-term methods and long-term method. Let's see what are the short-term methods. In that, the first one is a periodic transfer to fresh media. The culture can be maintained by periodically preparing a fresh culture from the previous stock culture. Many of the more common microbes remain viable for several weeks or months on a medium like Neutron agar. It is an advantageous as it is a simple method and any special apparatus are not required. However, it is easy to recover the culture. The transfer has a disadvantage of failing to prevent changes in the characteristics of a strain due to developments of variants and mutants, and there is risk of contamination in this process. The temperature and the type of medium chosen should be support slow growth rather than a rapid growth, so that the time interval between transfers can be as long as possible. Next method is the preservation of bacteria using glycerol. Bacteria can be frozen using 15% glycerol. The glycerol is diluted to 30% and an equal amount of glycerol and culture growth are mixed and it is dispersed into the tube and then frozen at -10°C. The viability of the organisms vary. For example, E. coli and Diplococcus pneumonia remain viable for 5 months. Haemophilus influenzae remain viable for 4 months. Neisseria meningitidis for 6 weeks. And Neisseria gonorrhea for 3 weeks. Next method is the storage by drying method. Spores of some microbes which are sensitive to freeze drying can be preserved by drying from the liquid state rather than the frozen state. There are different procedures of drying methods. The first one is the paper disc method. A thick suspension of bacteria is placed on sterile discs of thick absorbent paper, which are then dried over phosphorus pentoxide in a desiccator under vacuum. The second method is gelatin disc. Drops of bacterial suspension in gelatin are placed on sterile plastic petri plates and then dried off over phosphorus pentoxide under vacuum. Next method is the L drying or liquid drying. It's a useful alternative method of vacuum drying for the preservation of bacteria that are particularly sensitive to the initial freezing stage of the normal lyophilization process. Bacteria in small ampules are dried from the liquid state using a vacuum pump and a desiccant and a water bath to control the temperature. In the suspension of the organisms are dried under vacuum from the liquid state without freezing taking place. And apart from these methods, the organisms are also dried over calcium chloride in vacuum and are stored in the refrigerator. At such conditions, the organisms survive for longer period than the air-dried cultures. Next method is the storage by refrigeration. Culture medium can be successfully stored in refrigerators or cold rooms when the temperature is maintained at 4 degrees Celsius. At this temperature range, the metabolic activities of microbes slows down greatly and only small quantity of nutrients will be utilized. This method cannot be used for a very long time because toxic products get accumulated which can kill the microbes. Hence, this is also used for a short-term storage or preservation. Next, let's see some long-term methods of preservation. In that, the first one is mineral oil or liquid paraffin storage. In this method, sterile liquid paraffin is poured over the slant culture of microbes and stored upright at room temperature. Whereas cultures can also be maintained by covering agar slants by sterile mineral oil, which is stored at room temperature or preferably at 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. It limits the oxygen access that reduces the microorganism's metabolism and growth as well as to cell drying during preservation. The preservation period for bacteria from the genera Azotobacter and Mycobacterium is from 7 to 10 years and for Bacillus it can be stored for almost 8 to 12 years. This method of maintenance has the unique advantage that one can remove some of the growth under the oil with a transfer needle, inoculate a fresh medium and then still preserve the original culture. The simplicity of the method makes it attractive. Next method is the storage in saline suspension. Here the bacterial culture is preserved in 1% salt concentration in screw capped tubes to prevent evaporation. The tubes are stored in room temperature. Whenever needed, the transfer is made on agar slant. Next method is immersion in distilled water. Another inexpensive and low maintenance method for storing fungal culture is to immerse them in distilled water. The fungi can be stored in this method at 20 degrees Celsius and it survived up to 2 to 10 years depending upon the species. And this method was introduced by Castellani. In this, margins of well-grown fungal cultures are cut and transferred to cryo vials containing approximately 2 ml of sterile distilled water. And later, these vials can be stored. And for sporulating fungi, it involves inoculating agar slants of preferred media with fungal cultures and then incubating them at 25 degrees Celsius for several weeks to induce sporulation. Sterile distilled water is added aseptically to the culture and then the surface of the culture is scraped gently with a pipette to produce a spore and mycelial slurry. This is kept in sterile glass vials at 25 degrees Celsius and to retrieve a culture, 200 to 300 microliter of the suspension is removed from the vial and placed on fresh medium. Next is the storage in sterile soil. It is mainly applied for the preservation of sporulating microorganisms such as Fusarium, Penicillium, Alternaria, Rhizopus, and all these proved successful for storing sterile soil. Soil storage involves inoculation of 1 ml of spore suspension into soil and this soil have to be autoclaved twice and incubating at room temperature for 5 to 10 days. The initial growth period allows the fungus gradually to become dormant. The bottles are then stored at refrigerator. Viability of the organism is found around 70 to 80 years with this technique. Next method is a preservation by lyophilization or freeze drying. It is a vacuum sublimation technique. Freeze drying can satisfactorily preserve many kinds of bacteria that would be killed by ordinary drying. In this process, a dense cell suspension is placed in small vials and frozen at minus 60 to minus 78 degrees Celsius. The vials are then connected to a high vacuum line. The ice present in the frozen suspension sublimes under the vacuum, that is, it evaporates without going through the liquid water phase. This results in dehydration of the bacteria with a minimum damage to delicate cell structures. And then the vials are then sealed off under vacuum and stored in a refrigerator. By freezing the cells in a medium, it should contain certain lyoprotectant like sucrose, and the freezing must be very rapid with the temperature lowered to well below 0 degrees Celsius, that is, it can be ranging from minus 20 to minus 78 degrees Celsius, and the lyophilized cultures are stored in the dark in refrigerators, which is around 4 degrees Celsius. Many microbes preserved by these methods have remained viable and unchanged in their characteristic more than 20 years. It is very advantageous as only minimal storage space is required to preserve these small vials. Next method is the cryopreservation, that is freezing in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degrees Celsius or in the gas phase above the liquid nitrogen at minus 150 degrees Celsius. And this helps survival of pure cultures for long storage time. In this method, the microorganisms of culture are rapidly frozen in liquid nitrogen at minus 196 degrees Celsius in the presence of stabilizing agents such as glycerol or dimethyl sulfoxide that prevent the cell damage due to formation of ice crystals, and it promotes cell survival. By this method, species can remain viable for 10 to 30 years without undergoing change in their characteristics. And the small vials can be sent conveniently through the mail to other microbiology laboratories when packaged in a special sealed mailing containers. These lyophilized cultures can be revived by opening the vials, adding liquid medium and transferring the rehydrated culture to a suitable growth medium. One of its disadvantages is that it is quite expensive. Next method is the storage in silica gel. The microbes can be stored in silica gel powder at low temperature for a period of 1 to 2 years. The basic principle in this technique is quick desiccation at low temperature, which allow the cell to remain viable for a long period of time. Some of the species which are preserved on anhydrous silica gel are Saccharomyces cerevisiae, Aspergillus nidulans, Pseudomonas gentrificans and E. coli. Let's come to the conclusion. Whichever technique is used for the preservation and maintenance of industrially important organism, it is essential to check the quality of the preserved organism stock. Each batch of newly preserved cultures should be routinely checked to ensure their quality. The preservation is of great importance in the field of science, and it helps in research purposes, industry, as well as in the biotechnological field.